morning. Welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to try playing the Goth Family generationally. So through the Sims series, starting with the Sims 1. It's actually my first time playing the Sims 1. I was very lucky I found a YouTuber who showed a link of how to download and install the Sims 1 on a Windows 10 computer. I will link her in the comments because yes, that was a blessing. I didn't start playing the Sims until the Sims 2. I didn't start until 2006. That was my first game, but I wanted to give this one a go because this is where it all started. So this is the Goth family, as you see, Mortimer, their daughter Cassandra, and Bella, who is in the family in this version. She has not disappeared yet. Spoiler alert, if you haven't played The Sims 2 after, what, like, almost 20 years. But this is where we start. So as you see, Bella, Mortimer, and Cassandra all have really good relationships. They live together in this beautiful two-bedroom, two-story house. No Alexander yet. He doesn't exist in this game. So Mortimer works as a test subject in the science career. Bella is currently unemployed, and Cassandra, being a child, is enrolled in school. So that's where we are with them. So what we will be doing today is just playing through and seeing what happens in The Sims 1 life. Is it something where, we can parallel between other Sims games? So in the Sims 1 download, it comes with all the expansions, which includes making magic. So as you see, we got one of the magic starter kits delivered by the mystery man that was on our porch a little while ago. So I'll have Mortimer open the box, but he actually needs to get ready for work. So at 8 a.m. sharp, the school bus and any carpool will arrive. Pick him and Cassandra up, so I have to have them available. I don't want them interacting with something long and drawn out while we're waiting on carpool. But Cassandra, in the interim, is gonna go ahead and, or I'm sorry, Bella is gonna try to interact with the machine. As you see, you can't really interact with it without having the sword, I'm sorry, magic wand first. So it's gonna take a little bit of time to really use whatever that is that they brought. So once everyone left for school and work, the welcome committee arrives. So Bella's still home because, as I said, she doesn't work. She gets to meet Bob and Betty. They are the family from the tutorial. I did the tutorial offline just because I already kind of know The Sims, and the tutorial is maybe 5 minutes, so not that long, just to show you how to play The Sims in general. But as you see, we're going to greet Bob first and then greet Betty, which is his, I'm assuming, wife in this game. There's a couple options for greetings, and then once you've done the greeting, it unlocks a normal looking, social menu where you can pick different interactions. What I did notice in The Sims 1 is that there's no way to have a group conversation, so I have to individually talk to each one and pick which interactions I want to do. I assume they don't wander off too far, if you're not talking to them. But I'm gonna have her go back and forth between Betty and Bob and just kind of get to know
When
what was going on there.
Alexander,
So, The Sims 1 also has really hard interactions. As you see, my Sim was interested in boating, and she talked to Betty about it, and Betty was not interested. So I got a negative friendship minus for asking about interests, even though there's really no way to know what their interests are. The control panels here just kind of tell us about their level of friendship, but not necessarily, what they're interested in. It seems like Bob does not like talking about cats, so maybe we won't talk to him about cats anymore. He also doesn't like talking about cars, so doesn't, and I'm not really sure what Bob wants to talk about. Doesn't seem like we're on the same page, but that's okay. We're gonna keep trying because these are our only social interactions. Well, Cassandra and Mortimer are at school and work all day. Bella's kind of on her own. I didn't make her get a job in this version because I don't think it really sticks with the lore of the story. As we know, spoiler alert, if you haven't played The Sims 2 yet, Bella ends up disappearing in The Sims 2. So since she's gone, it doesn't really make sense for this, generational story to have her work because she wouldn't obviously be working in the second one. This is the next part of the series. So I'm gonna send Betty and Bob home because they really don't seem to be enjoying talking to Bella very much. They seem kind of maybe irritated at the topics that she wanted to talk about. So let's go ahead and get them off of our porch. And maybe we can entertain ourselves with the things in the house. So the house already came pre-furnished. with one bathroom, two bedrooms, like I said, living room, kitchen, and those kind of things. So their needs deplete pretty quickly, but I'm gonna go ahead and have her read for a minute. A random interaction happened while she was sitting outside. A cat, which is another expansion pack in The Sims 1, her pets is, I guess, gonna approach her on her patio or, porch or whatever that she has in the front of the house. That's kind of cool. I wish we had more interactions like
Pretty,
that in The
pretty
Sims 4.
cat.
I feel like
Oh,
with
but
when I
you're
play
so look
pets in The Sims 4, I have
red,
to
you're
adopt
blue.
pets because they don't really come up to you unless you
Oh,
live in
Becca,
Brindleton
how'd
Bay,
you
where then
come?
they come into all the bars and the restaurants, and then there's pets everywhere. But if you don't live in that one world in The
Here
Sims
we
4,
woo.
then you don't really see pets
Here woo.
like too often.
Meow.
So it's cool that she's just
Crump
hanging
on
out.
the
It doesn't
pot.
really seem like you can adopt it this way. Maybe it's a
Chihuahua,
stray
Pika Pika.
or a wild cat, but
Pika.
I mean, it seems pretty
Cause you.
friendly. It's willing to play and stay for a little bit.
Cause you
Helps build her
valuable.
social, which is nice,
Fruit
since
Pika.
she, again, is
Fruit
home most
Pika.
of the day. So the carpool comes at 8, leaves at 9, and then they don't reappear until, 3 or 4 in the afternoon. So it's a pretty long gap between when they leave and when they come back. And the time seems to move a little bit slower in The Sims 1. I'm also playing on one speed to show you what I'm seeing. Because normally I play in 2 or 3 speed, but I don't want to miss anything. So the pets can also interact with themselves. Another cat kind of popped up here on the lot randomly, and he got to interact with the first cat, which was interesting, without having to be prompted. So I'm gonna go have Bella deal with these newspapers. That's something I also forgot. In The Sims 4, we don't have newspapers or news in general. But in The Sims 1 and 2, there were newspapers. And in The Sims 1, there's also a magazine that comes to your door that tells you who's hot, which I guess is in relation to the Superstar expansion pack with the celebrity gameplay. I'm not 100% sure. Hopefully, we get into some of that today. But as you see, it's like, who's
Best
hot
Bell
in
Ryan
Studio Town?
in
And
the
it lists
Pastime
kind of
Tunnels.
random people. So I don't know what the levels mean from 1 to 10. I'll explore that more if I play deeper into the expansions. Mortimer comes home, which, like I said, is about 3 to 4, depending on carpool. And, it seems like the buses and cars
Best
can't go
Bell
around each other,
Delilah, Rose
so they
Bell
have to
Delmer,
wait until
Gayla
both people
Dodo.
are out and then they can drive off. So there's no homework in The Sims 1, so Cassandra doesn't have to do anything. The only way to really up their grades, I guess, is to just keep sending them to school every day in a good mood with good, stats for their needs. If they don't go to school, if they miss the bus, there's no other way to get them to school, and then they would be losing grade points. I think it's a grade a day for every day that they miss. So right now, Cassandra, I believe, starts off with a B. So if she stops going for 2 or 3 days, she'll fall into the DF range, and then she can be taken away by child services. Hopefully, that's not the case. So now that everyone's home, let's see how they interact as a family. So I'm gonna let them do some things autonomously because there's not a lot to do in their homes. In The Sims 1, they don't really have a television, and I'm not gonna buy one. I'm gonna let them interact based on their personalities with the things that they already have in the house, which is pretty on par. It reminds me a lot of the house they have in The Sims 2. No leftovers for the cooking. So if you make dinner or breakfast, you have to basically eat it all, or it'll have like flies around it, and you'll have to throw it out. So that's where we are. Mortimer is looking like the last one to eat, but he's getting there. There's not a call to meal option,
Can
so
all of
they
us
just kind of
not
have to either
grab a hand?
autonomously get the food or direct them to go get the food. So that would also kind of help if they want to eat together. As you see with Bella and Cassandra, they also don't have a lot in common. They're getting little negative social marks because they, I guess, don't have the same interests. But I'm not sure what they're interested in. And who picked airplane as the topic? Because neither Mortimer nor Cassandra like it, but that's what they seem to be talking about. So I will try to figure out the social a little bit more, because that's so strange that, even as a family, which thankfully they autonomously talked during the meal since that wasn't something I could trigger for them. But, we'll see how it goes. Bella is, she seems like a pretty cool mom. She's home, she takes care of the house, she takes care of the family. She does interact with her daughter. It seems like she likes to interact with her, talk with her, play with her. So as they get further into the evening, I did let Mortimer kind of, like I said, explore the house, and he wanted to gain some creativity skills. So he went ahead and did that. I'm gonna change their bed. The Sims 1 is a little bit different when it comes to Woohoo. You can't really trigger that on a regular bed. I guess you can trigger if you're trying to like make a baby, you have to have the Sims play in a vibrating bed or kiss and hug a lot, I guess. Or you can randomly get a pop-up from like an adoption agency asking if you want to adopt a baby. I don't know if that's gonna happen in this game. I bought them the vibrating bed anyways, but I don't see the option to play in it. So maybe this is not the right bed. That's the only heart-shaped bed I saw in build mode. So build and buy mode's a little bit different. In The Sims 1, there's not as many options. It's a little bit more scarce. But I know it's an older game from 2000. It's either 2000 or 2001. Is when the first one came out on Windows PC. I do like that they're able to both sleep in it. It, you know, still functions a regular bed, it just doesn't seem to give me the choice of playing around or woohooing or whatever they're gonna call it in this one. I wanted to try to see if I could have organically in the game Alexander. I mean, that would be a great parlay into The Sims 2, which is another game that you can, you know, if you have that option, if you were able to snag it when they were giving it away at Origin a couple years back. But as you see, I'm putting them to bed for the night because he has to work in the morning. They have interactions to kiss and stuff outside of the bed, but I don't know how you're supposed to trigger it inside of the bed. I have noticed with the Sims, they just move so slow. Like, I want them to move faster. You know, I don't know. So we'll see if we can get them to smooch or something. Maybe that'll
Oh,
make the
Daddy.
bed better for them. I like the passion that they have. This kiss is very loving and affectionate. And then I feel like the kisses in The Sims 4 are kind of non-romantic or more platonic, I guess. They don't seem like two people who really love each other a lot. But I'm gonna send them to bed because it doesn't seem like it's making a difference too much in their how they're interacting with each other. So hopefully I can get a good night's sleep because their energies are kind of low. Bella, I'm not as worried about since she doesn't work, but Mortimer has to be in a good mood for work. So I noticed while it was on 3 speed that there were like these green people moving around the house. I think they're ghosts. There is a graveyard, a pretty extensive graveyard in the backyard of the Goth house in The Sims 1. They have about 8 or 9 headstones, and so I guess triggered randomly at about 1 a.m., ghosts start popping out of the headstones and just kind of wandering around. That's super creepy. It reminds me of The Sims 2 Goth House, where they also have a bunch of things in the graveyard that kind of pop out and mess with the house. These ghosts in The Sims 1 don't really mess with the house, but they do move around. So as you see, this ghost has woken up Mortimer. I woke Bella up on purpose. I wanted her to go mourn outside. And poor Mortimer was, I guess the ghost went through him a couple of times, and that woke him up. Just a note in The Sims 1, Sims do not like to be woken up before their energy bar is full. So you're gonna see him throw like a little tantrum for being disturbed, even though he did get to sleep for a few hours. Cassandra's upstairs and nothing's bothering her. So it seems like the ghosts only come to the floor that the tombstones are on. So thankfully, Cassandra will get an uninterrupted night. So let me put him back to sleep and see if he can get any more rest. And I'll bring Cassandra back. I'm sorry, Bella back and see if she's gonna go back to sleep. Because her energy is also pretty low. She's trying to paint. It's kind of late to be painting. I do notice that the Sims don't really hear each other a whole lot. Like, you would think that Cassandra being upstairs would hear her parents kind of throwing a fit from being woken up by the ghost, but she didn't hear anything and she didn't come out of her room. So the ghosts just kind of wander around until the sun comes up. I noticed they stayed till about 4 or 5 a.m. and then they left. So the next morning, you know, I got her up. I want her mom to cook and do that kind of thing so Mortimer and Cassandra can start getting ready. It's kind of hard sharing a bathroom. It takes them a long time to bathe and use the toilet. So they get to take turns using the one bathroom they have. So I'll let Bella cook. Just kind of get them started for the morning. They can have something. Doesn't give you an option of what to cook. So I don't know. Because it's like a brown bowl that turned into a plate. Doesn't seem like a breakfast item, but maybe they're having hash browns or something potato based, which would make a lot more sense. Can't really tell what they're eating necessarily. But she's gonna eat by herself since no one else seems to be ready to eat yet. And then unfortunately, I took so long to cook that they both have to go to carpool. So they're gonna be going a little bit hungry outside in carpool. But that's fine. I'll let Bella enjoy the rest of the day to herself. Maybe she can do some cleaning, get some of the recycling stuff up. Maybe that cat will come back and visit. But yeah, they're leaving. So carpool comes, like I said, picks them up. Unfortunately, the bus can't leave until the car leaves because they can't go through each other. So Mortimer was taking almost to 9 o'clock to leave. Bella didn't really do much exciting today. She just cooked and cleaned. So now it's nighttime. Everyone's home. Kids home. And now we're gonna try to use the phone. I forget that in The Sims 1, they don't have cell phones. So if you want to make any sort of calls to any services or other Sims, you have to use a wall phone, which is not always the easiest thing to do. So as you see, she's trying to talk about peace, but I guess Bob doesn't like peace, and their phone call was cut short. So I don't know. I'm still not sure how the socializing works. Who decided that Bella liked peace? I'm gonna try to have Mortimer interact with her a bit because I'm not sure again how to trigger them to have a baby, and the bed doesn't seem to be a good option. So I'm gonna see if they can maybe kiss a bit, spend a bit of time. And Cassandra's just gonna be flitting around, getting her needs met through the bathroom while they do this. So as you see, he's coming up with sweetness. She seems really into it. Definitely very interesting sound effects in The Sims 1 when they do certain things. She seemed really receptive to that first one, and it improved their relationship, which they already have a pretty strong one to begin with. But she doesn't like that at all. She's like, get away from me. Back off. So I don't know if she's just tired or what, but she does not seem to enjoy those last two kisses. So I'm probably gonna leave her alone. She doesn't seem interested. Maybe they should just go to bed. They seem pretty tired. I know she's tired. Her energy is really low because she got woken up in the middle of the night by the ghost also. And then went out to the backyard to mourn. So she's probably exhausted. So I'll go ahead and have all the babies sleep for the night and see what tomorrow brings. Because it seems like today they're not going to get a lot done. Again, these needs deplete really fast. Just one day of school and they're already ready for bed at like 9 o'clock. Now Mortimer had gotten a promotion, so now he works a different position, which is now a night position. Kind of sucks for him because he worked a full day until 3 and then has to work again at 11 p.m. So I'll let him sleep for an hour. He'll be cranky when I wake him up, but I'm gonna let him rest and then I'm gonna send him to work on time, ideally. Okay, next morning, Bella's getting up. Oh no. Okay, so a fire is broken out on the stove. Bella doesn't really have any of the cooking skill. I haven't made her study that. You can study on the bookshelf for the cooking skill, but I didn't do that for her. I just have her cook every day. So the Sims act pretty much the same in terms of fire. They freak out. It is weird that no one else in the house is freaked out. Sandra just left the bathroom and she didn't even look at the fire or really seem concerned about it. That's interesting. I'm gonna have Bella call for the fire department. I didn't think to buy a smoke alarm. I don't know if that would trigger the fire department in this game. In Sims 2 it does. So I'm gonna keep Cassandra, hopefully away from the fire. I don't think children can die in the Sims franchise, like from a fire or anything like that. So she's probably fine. I want her to finish her chores before the bus comes at 8. I want to move Bella out of the way though, because it seems like the fire is spreading a little bit faster. And then Mortimer is still asleep in his room. So it's really interesting that the Sims aren't woken up by the fire, because I've noticed in other games, if there's a fire anywhere in the house, the Sims will either all congregate into the fire area and freak out over the fire, or they'll all jump out and leave. But that's all that I have for you today. Let's see if there's a part two. If you have any suggestions, or if you've played The Sims 1 before, let me know in the comments, and we'll go from there.